To finish off the character with a nice render, move back to the shading workspace. Earlier, we excluded the lighting collection, so bring that one back since we will need the light and the camera that's in it. With the shortcut numpad 0, we can switch to the camera view, and for more intuitive positioning of a nice camera angle, you can toggle camera to view, which you can find in the sidebar, so that the camera follows the viewport navigation. Once you're happy with the camera angle, just make sure to toggle the option off again, so that you don't accidentally move the camera around. For a nice, simple studio lighting environment, we can add a plane on the ground level, scale it up, and extrude and bevel the edges on the back for a smooth back wall. Just make sure to switch to smooth shading in the context menu, so you don't have to subdivide the model a lot to not be able to count the faces. In rendered mode, we can then clearly see the lighting that is coming from the one light we have right now. From here on out, set up some extra area and spotlights based on the three-point lighting setup. I can really recommend a medium-sized warm area light as the key light, a big cold area light as the fill light, a narrow bright spotlight as the rim light, and you can even add some extra global illumination by adding a color to the world environment. The size of these lights really only defines how soft the shadows will be. The spotlight can even have a maximum distance, which is really useful. And I can really recommend to try to place the spotlights in a way that it won't shine directly on the ground and only really provides an extra rim to the character. You can even have more rim lights for extra control. You can add as many lights as you want. You can add some more color to the scene by picking a nice color for the ground to go with the character. I can also recommend to pose the character slightly by aligning some of the objects a bit differently. That extra bit of asymmetry can add a lot of appeal to the render. The painted texture can also be further mixed and adjusted with some more nodes in the shader editor. Use the render passes in the viewport to see specific information like the base color, the diffuse lighting, or just the specular highlights. This way you can fine-tune some aspects of the lighting and the render a bit further. In the output settings, you can find the usual sliders like for resolution and aspect ratio, but also extra effects in the render settings like ambient occlusion, screen space reflections, and bloom can really enhance the look of your render. Once you're done, press F12 and the final image will be rendered. But this is only one possible character. To fit the idea of this one, I created more based on primitive objects that you can add in Blender. And there are sheer endless design ideas and opportunities of what you can create. You can also take the Blender Fundamentals videos on rigging and animation and take these characters even further to the next level. And once you're ready to dive deeper into Blender, there are many more techniques and workflows out there to create art, films, games, and so much more. So I hope these videos gave you a nice first insight in how to start creating things in Blender by yourself. So have fun getting creative with Blender.